Hey everyone, welcome to episode 20. We're back from outer space. We totally didn't just record episode 19 like a minute ago. If anybody asks, especially Andrew, it's been at least a week. Okay?
2 or 3 weeks, really.
This is our secret. Anyway, so, if you didn't watch episode 19, what episode 20 is about is we got food poisoning from eating out of a rusty can of condensed milk, which is as gross as I can think of. It being, we're coming back from Desolation Point,
right?
Yep. We're heading to the mountain biome. We're in the highway. No.
Coastal highway. Yeah.
Yeah, we're in coastal highway. We're headed towards.
Go through the mine to Pleasant Valley.
Right.
Check out the farmhouse we've seen down long term.
Right. So we're going. We're heading back to our big stronghold place to get out like supplies. So that we can make a
so
go
we
of
can
it.
Go down on the mountain.
But right now we have less than 1 hour of daylight left, and I don't really want to walk from this place to the mine in the dark.
The darkest dark.
So we're gonna
need all the lantern fuel we have to go through the mine.
We're gonna, you know, enjoy it. I like how passing time makes me tired. I like that. I don't know why.
It also apparently makes you the thirstiest guy to ever have thirstied.
Okay. Do you want to go ahead and explain some of the changes they made since, the last big patch?
Yeah,
in case somebody didn't watch the last episode.
They added in this crazy-ass radio menu. They've changed all the menus, too, where you eat and stuff. The menu when you're at a stove is different. Crafting is handled a little bit differently. You no longer make everything at a workbench. Now there's, once again, some stuff you can craft without one. I don't think, hey, let's go to a book real quick. Because the distinction might be, you know how we were trying to...
Yeah, you use them as, like, wood.
Right.
Okay, you don't use them as tinder.
Well, because the way it used to be is you'd harvest it from it. So I was wondering if we could still harvest a tinder plug from a book.
Nah. I think books are pretty much just shitty wood.
I wonder. Maybe magazine rolls.
2 hours of darkness left. I think it passed time for an hour.
Yeah.
Less than 1 hour. Oh, snap.
What?
Check this out. We got an achievement. It kicked us out of sleeping. What an asshole. Did you see the achievement we got?
Yeah, was it 40 days?
Yeah. Let's sleep for more time. That's enough. Eat and drink. Do both at the same time.
Let's get our beat to shit can of sardines, maybe?
Yeah, it's... doesn't have quality. So, we can do that.
I gotta randomly kill us for no reason.
Fucking, that was dumb as shit that I did that.
Yeah, how are we supposed to know rusty camp in this milk meant, you know, fucking botulism or whatever? Like, it's not like it said swollen can of condensed milk or dented as shit can of condensed milk.
On fire can of condensed milk.
Clearly poisoned can of condensed milk.
Can of condensed milk with a tiny pinhole in it. Or probably somebody injected something into it. Maybe I'm getting too creative now.
Can't convince my full of razor blades.
Oh god, I didn't expect it to be so chunky and sharp.
It said it was with extra razor blades, but I didn't think it'd have so many razor blades.
Oh god. What happened in Event Horizon? Everyone started drinking and there's milk and razor blades in it.
I don't remember that part of the movie. It was a pretty crazy movie, so it's possible I just forgot part of it.
That's what happens when you go into the warp.
Razorblade milk?
Man, I'm kind of sad that we finished recording Space Marine today to date this video. Although that should come out far after this comes out because of scheduling. But pretty sad it's over.
No more Space Marine deployed.
We probably should play that Warhammer 40K 2, Dawn of War 2. Play the single player on that one's pretty cool. It's got a, you basically choose what faction you want to play as, and it gives you heroes.
Cool kids play the Space Marines.
The Space Marines are pretty hype. Who else is hype? The Orcs are pretty hype. The Tyranids are weird, because in that one, you don't get to control, or you don't get, like, four heroes like you do with everyone else. You get just your Hive Lord, and you make him, like, super great. Hit me up with a map, would you? I want to make sure we're going the right way.
It's a good thing we did that map deal.
Yeah. Yeah, I figured we shouldn't be going over that bridge. Anyway, Tyranids.
Down that road.
Imperial General is also a cool guy you get to play as.
Oh yeah, I forgot. They, don't they treat,
the Imperial Guard as their own faction?
Guard as separate factions?
Yep.
Donald War 1 is also pretty fun. It's a, old school StarCraft 1 style RTS.
Well, Donald War 2 is too. It's just,
No, it's more of a isometric strategy game. Because it's, you've got your hero units. And
see, I didn't know. I thought it had a multiplayer option just like that one. You
know, I don't know. Skirmish. Maybe it knows, but never played it.
Oh, that's good. Anyway. We're still really excited for Eternal Crusade, which is going to be awesome. It pretty much can't be bad, because it's made by the same people who made Space Marine, and they're putting some serious dedication into it.
Yeah, when I get some extra money, I'm going to buy into Eternal Crusade.
Yep. You guys should support them. They're making a great game. Don't even know if it's good yet, but it's great.
You might not know what Eternal Crusade is, since, you know, our other video is going to be in the distant future. And Eternal Crusade is, if you took Space Marine, you should check on that for cool. If you took Space Marine and made it an MMO shooter, and also you could play any faction except for Tyranid or Necron.
Yeah. Right now. And Tau. You can't play as Tau.
Well, yeah, right. But they're you can't play as Orc either. But they're adding Tau and Orc.
Eldar and Orc.
Eldar and Orc, sorry. I thought they were adding Tau too.
No, Tau's not scheduled right now.
They will probably add Tau, though. I'd be a little bit surprised if they added Necron.
And not.
And I'd be very surprised if they added Tyranid.
They're just too different.
Right.
I mean, at least the Necron, you know, have like a military type thing going on.
Well, and they, you know, they never make Tyranid a player class, because then there's something that if they want to gang everyone up on, they can gang everyone up.
Yeah, no, there's PvE, Tyranid's attack, and
right.
Yeah. Do I need to go up?
Yeah, keep going the direction you're going.
Okay, so, yeah, that game's going to be pretty cool. It's basically just like giant map where you hold points against other factions, like King of the Hill. And if you leave something undefended, Tyranids come in and they take it over, and that's no one's. So that's pretty cool.
There's a class system too, I believe.
There is. You can be like a wizard, or a librarian, or a heavy bolter, which is what I'm gonna be every single time, all the time.
You can be a fucking
exterminator.
The junk guy. I'm trying to remember what they're called. The guys with the jetpacks.
Angels of Death. Gotcha.
No, the Angels of Deaths are. The female, not really Space Marines, but like Space Marines.
Those are the Sisters of Battle. Yeah. Is that what they're called? Sisters of Battle? Daughters of Battle? Sisters of Battle?
Sisters.
Okay.
I wonder if there's going to be an option to play as a, the Met guy here over,
Dreadnought,
yeah.
It'll probably be like a heavy vehicle thing where you can spawn in, you know. Kind of like what they do in Battlefield.
I hope it's not handled as clunkily as Battlefield.
Nah, who cares, man? You're gonna be playing. You're gonna be playing as a Chaos or a regular Dreadnought.
Or a Mech Boy.
Or a Mech Boy. Or an Avatar. What do they call the giant things Eldar use? The skit, the Wraith. Yeah, the Wraiths.
I wonder if there's gonna be Dark Eldar.
They don't usually use Dark Eldar. They're not a very popular faction.
They kind of are, because people like Eldar, but a lot of people don't like the fact that they're the closest thing to a non-Imperium good guy.
Oh yeah, they like the Imperium to be the only good guys.
Well, no, they want to be, the dark and edgy version of Eldar.
And dark and edgy.
Because they like the fact that the Eldar are space elves and they don't want to be Eldar.
Yeah. Andrew was asking me questions before we started playing Warhammer about the difference between fantasy and 40K. And he's like, so, in 40K, did all the fantasy races just leave Earth? And, fuck.
I don't think it matters.
Did they all just leave Earth and, like, take over different planets? And I'm just like, no. No, it's totally different. They started out on different planets. And he's like, right, but... What is this? Robar Wood.
That's where the dead ends.
I was checking to see what the, was on the ground. It's a lot of coal. Don't need any, though. It's just funny that they literally just took the same pieces and just, made them spacey.
I'm trying to remember if they're actually supposed to be set in the same galaxy or whatever. Because the other thing you gotta remember is the fact that the Emperor is...
He's the same Emperor, isn't he?
Yeah, he's the same guy that was the Emperor in Fantasy Warhammer.
Well, I mean, that's because the Emperor is love. The Emperor is life. The
Emperor is eternal, bro.
Even if Horus tried to fuck him. Fuck Horus. Guy's an ass chomper.
Yes, our darkest chapter of history, the ass chomper heresy.
Yeah, it doesn't have very much at all. I should still be able to drain it. That's not depressing. That'll take your single rifle round that you never got to use on yourself because you got collapsed on.
Getting collapsed on your face was probably a
faster,
not a bad way to go, because it was a big, huge surprise.
Boom, surprise.
What if it wasn't, like, though? Desperately kill yourself. You just go, let's go through this mic, collapse.
What if it wasn't? What if it wasn't a surprise? What if you knew it was happening and you just kind of moved into it?
You'd have to have some crazy reflexes to move into a collapsing mine.
Not if you're Canadian, Dave. They can sense that shit coming. I mean, I think that mainly is for avalanches, but it's kind of the same thing.
I was not aware that Canadians had superpowers.
You didn't know that? When?
Big pop.
You know what we were never able to open earlier? This. Yeah. Come on, good stuff. Bad.
No.
It's still bad. I know we don't need the cloth because we're about to get to the place where we have like 50. I still can't stop, picking it up every once in a while.
I'm just bummed that it's not all we need to make torches anymore.
Oh yeah, you need a little bit of kerosene?
Right, it's like...
That doesn't make any sense.
Right, like if we need kerosene, what's the point of making torches because we just use the fucking lamp?
Maybe it's for when you don't have a lamp yet. The fuck is...
No, this is the right way.
Oh yeah, because
we're trying to get
right
to like the other side of it, because there's like some rifle rounds over there, or a jerry can or something.
There was rifle rounds. Right there, yeah. But it's too bad. take two boards and make a bridge is not an option. Having some more port.
I'm having some more port.
Do you have any starboard?
Yeah, when you go to a formal dinner in England, typically, like, well, anywhere in formal dinner, you know, it's traditional. You pass everything to the right.
Yeah.
You pass the port to the port.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's left, right?
Right.
No, it's left.
Correct.
I'm doing it on purpose, Dave.
I know you are. That's why I said correct. Cut that shit off.
Do you remember back in the day when we used to tell my brother, and he's like, do I take a left or a right?
We'd always tell him to take a left, right?
Yeah.
Well, especially fucking Brett would tell him to take a left, right?
Hey, I take a left, right?
Okay, so we're up here and we want to go.
Jesus. Nope. Keep going down.
Yeah, right there.
That's not us.
Oh, fuck, we want to go.
Yeah, if you can't hear Dave, he's making stupid sounds.
Jet plane noises. Yeah, it's pretty great. I like it.
Dave's really bad at it.
I'm having a good time though. That's what matters.
Having a good time.
Having a ball. I don't want to stop at all.
Dave can't sing.
I cannot. That's true.
I never had the courage to tell him that because he loves it so much. I just love the. Okay, so I don't know if, what website is this. GamePedia or something?
Torana.com?
So whatever website this is...
I mean, you can find it on Steam.
Yeah.
When you search
the map.
Long Dark Maps.
So when you search for Long Dark Maps...
They're like, let me help you out,
the,
honey.
The standard one is this pretty nice one. And it has... One of the main icons on it is for a dead guy, right? And the dead guy icon is a dude doing karate.
Yeah, it looks like a guy doing a fucking... Flying Jackie Chan kick.
It's pretty great. Why is that the dead guy icon?
I don't know. Because it's supposed to be, like, sprawled out.
Okay, but no dude is that sprawled out.
Be careful you don't go off to the left because there'd be bars.
I'm saying that right away.
Alright.
At least I think so. I think my... I mean, what I do is I write an L on my left hand. That way when I look down, I can see the L and I know it's left. They taught me that in the army.
I should go to Dixon's sometime soon and get all you can eat tacos. You do that on either Tuesday or Thursday.
Go where?
Dixon's Chili.
Where the fuck is that?
There's several of them in the old part of town. There's one Independence on Sterling, I think, and it's the one that's not in the hood. That's Harry Truman used to eat there, so they've got like 40,000 Harry Truman pictures stapled to the wall, like every other old building in Kansas City where, you know, friends Harry Truman liked it.
Harry Truman grew up here before he bombed the Japs. Oh, Japanese.
Hey,
what?
In all fairness, some sons of bitches had it coming.
I mean, I suppose. In the whole war sense, yes. I don't think anybody deserves to get nuked, but if it ends the war, right? It's either that or they get firebombed.
I'm not saying anyone deserves to get nuked, but they didn't deserve to not get nuked.
Are you saying that they weren't doing us any favors?
Something like that. I actually support the MacArthur position.
Of
that
nuke
we should
everyone?
Use the nuke as much as possible when we're the only ones that had the technology.
Oh, you mean creating the DMZ with just nuclear blasts?
Yeah, by making a fucking, just nuclear bombing a giant crescent above North Korea so the Chinese can't reinforce them anymore. Well, no, he wanted to go even than that. He knew that the Soviets weren't doing us any favors. So his whole idea was, while we're still on the war footing, after Japan surrenders, we should have just attacked the Russians and bombed Moscow. And honestly, we probably should
have. When they were at their weakest?
Right. Because they were at their weakest and we were at our strongest. Like, instead of just stopping and letting them fucking build up, we should have just been like, oh man, you guys sure aren't doing us any favors.
Yeah, but I don't know. I would have been shady. Because, you know, you never knew it was going to happen.
The Russians had no illusions that they were anything more than our allies of convenience, because they were also not Nazis.
Fucking Spain.
Like let's be real here. Everyone knows that, you know, one of the primary reasons we got involved with World War II was our special relation with the English.
Oh, where we used to be, like, their subject?
Oh.
And now we're not? But now we're bros?
Right. It turns out that's what happens when you share a common culture with another country.
A decent culture. Not Canada. Sorry. I got a cough.
I don't know, man. I'm kind of a supporter of the political idea that that we should make a formal alliance between the English-speaking countries.
You mean just the ones that speak it as their main language, or what?
I basically mean us in the former Commonwealth.
In India?
No. I mean...
Well, I mean, India's, you know, was part of the English Empire for a long time. India
was part
time.
Of the English Empire, but it was never part of the, it was never truly part of the English Commonwealth, or whatever, like Australia and Canada was.
Yeah. I heard a wolf. Did you hear a wolf?
A little bit, yeah. Probably check those asses.
Dude, I don't think we're gonna need it. I remember having a lot of stuff. I mean, we can. We might have already done it.
We might have, actually.
And there were wolves in here! Nope.
Location discovery doesn't think you've ever been here.
This place is a piece of shit.
You're not wrong.
One of those guys dead.
I'd kill myself too if I lived in this shithole.
Single rifle round, not bad.
Box of crackers.
I'm unboxing myself. Point.
0.10.
It's full at 0.26. Did you let the tannins breathe on that? You should really leave that open.
No, that's how you wind up with a bottle of vinegar.
No, not open like for a long period of time. Like, open that drink.
This is a dessert wine. It's not a fucking
fancy wine.
Well, no, it is a fancy wine, but it's not. It's not like it's a.
Oh, we've checked this place.
Fucking Burgundy or something.
Just kind of surveying the situation here. Hey, what's a besides Atlas Shrugged? What's another Ann Coulter book? Or Ayn Rand?
Ayn Rand book.
What's an Ann Coulter book?
I don't know. I can't America and so can you.
Because let's use that one as a reference.
Another Ayn Rand book would be The Fountainhead or...
shit. Because it has to be a book I'm willing to burn.
You know, honestly, Ayn Rand books are...
I can tell.
Ayn Rand is not wrong. Is not right. But
not wrong either.
No, she's wrong. That, you know, basically what happened is Ayn Rand grew up in the Soviet Union, and she decided the Soviet Union sucked shit. So clearly the right thing to do was just do the exact opposite of what the Soviet Union would do. But it turns out that's also kind of retarded.
Let me check these.
Yeah. Like, that whole altruism is,
is fake.
It wasn't altruism is fake, it's altruism is bad. Like, categorically, period. That's a pretty fucking autistic worldview.
Staying alive solely on soda.
Like, you know, for someone that says they're big on free market, for someone to say altruism is dead, period, they sure don't understand
Adam Smith,
yeah.
Yeah, that's something I don't like. Is when people are like, oh my god, Adam Smith wouldn't want us helping people. If they're trying to, if a person is making enough of an effort to help, I can't even get that. Wow, that's shitty.
No, are you trying to tell me that the operative phrase in enlightened self-interest is enlightened?
Yes.
And you've got to, like...
You've got to understand that helping other people helps yourself sometimes.
No, Dylan, wealth is a zero-sum game. I gotta get it all. It's like Pokemon. I gotta catch all of my...
50 means?
That's the best way to explain it. Wealth is Pokemon. You've gotta be a Wealthamon master.
Wealthamon. You know what my favorite chimp Pokemon is? Shoo.
I was a fan of Lightbulb myself.
That'll be useful.
I didn't take that.
That's fine, we don't need fucking...
We need more painkillers, because they're just everywhere in here.
Pills here!
You know what mechanic this game needs? The ability to turn the,
ability to get addicted to pain pills.
No, the ability to turn the lantern on, and then attach it to your belt or something.
Well, you mean it's totally possible with the whole lantern in your left hand while you hold a rifle with both hands?
They do need a pistol, though. The dog food? Fucking name, no.
Like, I just, like I said, I hope the pistol is like a 22, and you get kind of a lot of ammo for it. So
this is like an exact clone.
It fucking is, though. I hope the pistol is like a 22, and you get a decent amount of ammo for it, so you don't feel bad shooting rabbits.
But you can't kill large game.
Yeah, like maybe you can kill a wolf, but it takes two or three shots.
Yeah, if you made it fire fairly fast, and have less condition total, so you had to repair it more often, maybe, or give it like a 1% chance to just not fire.
Even if the condition didn't go down as fast, like shot for shot, you know, like even if the condition went down the same amount of shot for shot, is what I'm trying to say. But it does a lot less damage, so if you try and kill a wolf with it, you're shooting a bunch of times.
Yeah.
It's going to come out in the wash, because if you try and kill anything that's not rabbits with it, you're going to be shooting a lot of times, and that's going to mean your condition's going to go down and all that shit.
True.
But, you know, but if it's still, if it can kill a rabbit in one shot, and you found enough ammo that you didn't feel bad shooting rabbits with it, then that'd still be good, because then you can, you know, shoot rabbits with it, and not have to worry about using the shitty bow.
Do you want to go check out the Prepper's Cache?
No, those are,
Those are
possible bunkers.
Oh.
And that's what kind of bunker it will be if it's spawns there.
Oh! We already found a bunker, though. There's a food bunker.
It wasn't. It had a shitload of food.
You tired, Dave? Just a little guy?
No, not really. I'm just yawning a lot.
Make a pretty good time. We can't sprint. I knew this was going to be a long walk, so we couldn't get a Razor scooter.
Razor scooter on those roads. Fucking death trap.
Razor scooters were already a death trap, babe.
Exactly.
They needed to make four-wheeled ones.
You can just get two Razor scooters.
Holy shit, Dave. You just solved the world force problem.
Well, but a conduit, the omega core.
Oh my god. All we need now is some papyrus.
Let's go to the garage sale and get some razor scooters.
Do you remember, this was right when we weren't kids anymore. You know, after we stopped playing with things like razor scooters, they came out with, like, comfort scooters.
Yeah.
Like, and you could buy just from a store. They were not super expensive. I remember back when we had to actually, you know, use our feet to move.
They're basically the safer, wider version of hoverboards.
Yes. That girl who attached the hoverboard to lawn chair, that was pretty good.
That was a good one that was going around the internet. It's just a fucking girl. She got a lawn chair and put it in like a fucking wagon.
Yeah.
And then just put her fucking feet on her hoverboard and just...
I don't understand how those things are supposed to be hoverboards, though.
What, you mean if it's got wheels, it's not a hoverboard?
Yes. I mean, it's a fire trap is what it is.
Well, it's only a it's a fire trap in the same way that all lithium polymer binaries are a fire trap if you puncture them or charge them like a dipshit.
Or charge them too fast or something, right?
No, it's if the charge controller fails and it overcharges them, they get hot. But to have them catch fire, you've got to, like, leave them forever and not notice they're getting hot. And then if you puncture them while they're under load, they'll vent off hydrogen and get hot enough to ignite the hydrogen, and then they kind of explode because they're full of lithium. But, like, you know, basically, like, you know, you can do the same thing with your phone if you, like, shoot with a pellet gun while it's in your pocket.
Really?
Yeah.
Guys, next week we'll have video of this. One of us will not be here anymore. It'll probably be Andrew.
I have to get a convenience store mannequin. We can go down in the basement and shoot with a pellet gun. We have to get some fire extinguishers so we don't burn the house down. We'll do it in the backyard. It'll be fine.
It'll be fine.
Next week video from our backyard. Who's it work special? This is what happens if you puncture a lithium polymer battery.
Yeah, look at all this progress we're making. Got a good view.
That's kind of making me motion sick. Let's not do that.
I got it. How's that? Is that better?
It's actually worse, but...
I like how we're running against the wind now, and it's seriously slowing us down.
Oh, we're running against the...
I let some rains down in Africa.
We're running against.
What are you singing?
It's a song, right?
What are you singing?
Right against the wind.
Oh. Did you think I was saying that?
You did say. I mean.
No, did you think I was referencing it?
No, but you did it anyway on accident.
All I do is reference.
Let some rains down in Africa.
That is not how that song is sound.
No, I know. I've been drinking for the last several hours, alright? I'm not in the best singing condition anymore.
Dave, what time is it?
3 a.m.
Yeah, that's about right. Had to wait for my wife to retire to the bedroom so that we could record without Property Brothers being on in the background.
There's a reason these are the videos with the best sound quality, let's be real.
Yeah. I wish I had Andrew's mic, though. That thing is amazing. Just the fact that it has the gain on it.
Oh, yeah. You can actually adjust it with a slider instead of just being like, do you want 20 or 30? It's like, dude, this is a logarithmic scale. I don't need my choices being this much or 100 times this much.
Basically, I have a $20 mic, and he has a $100 mic. And if you've watched Saturday Morning RPG or Warhammer, you can tell a marked difference in the sound quality. A lot. Another thing is that I found the noise suppression button. That really helps too. Remember we almost died here?
I do remember that, yeah. It's like we'd go toe-to-toe with a grizzly bear. Turns out we were wrong.
And then we found out the other guy found out. And then he told us how to beat
it. That's where we want to be, bro.
No, it's not.
We just crossed one bridge. Right.
Dave's over there trying to be my navigator. Buddy's drunk. Like normal.
Oh, come on. That's not a fair statement.
Okay, not normal.
I'm frequently drunk. I don't know that normally drunk. That's over the line.
I like how one of the bridges is Contemplation Bridge, and the other one is Heartbreak Bridge.
Yeah, this is,
Country.
You know, this is Bummerino Avenue, so.
It's country as fuck.
No, it's Bummerino Avenue. You're driving down here all bummed out, heartbroken, Contemplation. The next one is I'm gonna kill myself, Causeway.
No, it's called the Long Curve, and it probably causes a lot of accidents.
It's funny, because it's not really very long or curvy, but.
Well, remember that, remember on Top Gear when they were, he was driving on that beach and he's like, this is 50
mile
beach.
It's called 90 mile beach.
Yeah.
Because it's exactly 55 miles long. I don't get it either.
Fuck it.
Good old New Zealand. It's a shame that they fired Jeremy Clarkson for punching a dude in the face and then everyone else quit. And now they've got new Top Gear that doesn't look very good. But apparently the entire Top Gear cast is now doing a show on Netflix. It's basically Top Gear that's not called Top Gear anymore.
Oh, did the other guys quit when he got fired?
Yeah, because they were all buds. And like, yeah, he punched a guy in the face.
So?
But apparently the guy he punched in the face was kind of a dick and had been fucking with him a lot.
Oh, kind of like the guy that Christian Bale yelled at?
Yeah,
he was like walking in front of the camera and stuff. Or he was walking,
He's walking for the lights and making like crazy shadows and shit.
I knew he was fucking with the boom, too, the boom light.
Yeah, like that's, like, you know, you hear, oh, Christian Bale flips out on this guy. It's like, Christian Bale's a method actor. They were in the middle of a scene, and this guy's, like, fucking stuff up enough to take Christian Bale out of the scene. And everyone's confused when he gets screamed at. Like,
you don't fuck with somebody who makes more money than you. That's just kind of a rule.
Moving up there?
Have we been up? Signal Hill?
Yeah.
Episode 7.
Yeah, you're right. It's a fucking tower on this map, and I don't know why. It's not actually a tower.
There is a tower. You just can't get up.
Right. It's just the fucking Bigfoot tracks.
What if it was Episode 7?
It's not Episode 7, but...
You wanna look? You got the YouTubes on your computer. I kinda wanna know now. One of the episodes we literally started there.
No, I mean, you're not wrong. But I think it was quite a bit later than 7 or just more like, yeah. No, it could have been around 7 because 10 was Bear Apocalypse. So it was. It might have been 7. It was probably 6, 7, or 8.
Got some dry skin. Hype your shit on YouTube.
Dry as shit on YouTube.
Dry as finger on YouTube. Heartbreak Bridge on YouTube.
That reminds me, you ever seen Heartbreak Ridge with the screamy guy?
Who?
Clint Eastwood.
No, I don't like Clint.
You don't like Clint Eastwood?
He's okay, like, I just don't like him much as you.
And he's basically just even older Harrison Ford.
Oh, he reminds me too much of your dad.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't even know what that means.
It's kind of like how I can't watch Woody Harrelson anymore.
That is a much... fairer comparison, because my dad looks like fucking Woody Harrelson, like, seriously, for real. My dad looks like he could be fucking Woody Harrelson's brother.
Stunt double?
But, I don't understand how Harrison, or how Clint Eastwood reminds you of my dad.
We'll have this conversation off YouTube, and so your dad watches these videos, I'm pretty sure.
That my dad... doesn't watch anything that's not like crazy car accidents on YouTube. Like, my dad watches old guy YouTube, which does not involve playing Long Dark, but that's fine. We'll have it off YouTube. I'm legitimately interested.
It mainly just has to do with him being real with them.
The anger and the racial slurs.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I didn't want to talk about racial slurs on YouTube. But, I mean, we're already bringing it up, so...
My dad is relatively old, but racial slurs are pretty much.
Yeah. I can't wait till I'm that old that no one cares anymore. And they just accept it. Also, welcome home. be funny if there were like a bunch of dead people in here.
That's the real question. Is what is the topic when we're in our 60s and 70s? That everyone's going to be like, oh, they don't need it. It was different then.
Gangs.
We already don't care about
transgender.
My God, I hope that doesn't become a big thing.
Really?
Yeah, really.
No,
yeah.
I mean, like, really.
Like, I'm sorry.
It's going to become a big thing.
I'm sorry, trees on YouTube. You're going to look like you're going to die.
Talk about... talk about transableness.
Oh, yeah. Della saw people that were trans-disabled for the first time on YouTube a couple hours ago. And I think she about lost her shit.
Let's go downstairs.
In all fairness, it's a pretty fucking...
fucked up thing.
Pretty fucking fucked up crazy thing, yeah. And like, as much as transsexual people are, you know, have a mental problem, if you go to the doctor, like, at least that's like, you know, hormonally based and somewhat based in science. Instead of just being like, I feel like I need to chop my legs off because reasons.
Raisins. Raisins.
Like...
We're moving really slow.
You know, yeah, you know, you're not a man that was born in a woman's body. Like, technically, maybe you're really kind of, but at least there's, like, a scientifically diagnosable reason why you feel that way.
Yeah, at least your hormones.
Right.
Hormones can make sense.
Fucking brain hormones are wrong and shit. But,
Oh, yeah, we got lots. Oh, yeah, this is going to be good.
I wonder how many skins we have. We might have enough for pants. So we put some in the file cabinet.
No, but we got cured rabbit pelt.
Aw, dude, we make some sweet mittens. Is there a deer hide stack, I wonder? That sounds like some retarded shit we do.
I'm just gonna drop all this down here.
Yeah, that's fine. Oh, we got more feathers. Do we get more feathers?
I don't know. We might have feathers upstairs. All I know is we don't need this shit, so I'm trying to put some of it away. And we should have wood upstairs.
So at the very least, furniture we can smash upstairs.
Damn right, there's furniture upstairs we can smash. That sounded like the eating sound.
It did.
How's Sonic doing?
He's fine. Well, yeah, I woke him up while I went to blanket.
That's fine. I got a hedgehog named Sonic. In case you didn't watch the old episodes. I didn't name him, my wife did. Oh, yeah, look at that.
What did it say? Gamey what?
Gamey wolf meat and venison. You can probably got to throw out the moldy wolf meat.
Yeah, probably.
In fact, if you want, we could probably spare it.
Yeah, although that autistic lady is supposed to have
that. Damn it. Don't call my wife autistic.
Hey, it presents differently in girls.
Ah, the big cabinet. Cured deer hide. Quite a bit of kerosene.
Sweet. Dale's not autistic. If any girl is autistic, it's that one friend of hers who I had a crush on, and we don't want to name names.
Well, now I'm just trying to figure out who it is.
I've only legitimately had a crush on one.
Is it Stoned Laura?
Well, it's not fucking Stoned Laura.
No, she's not stoned anymore.
I don't believe that for a second. Stoned Laura was so consistently and extremely stoned that she just was called Stoned Laura.
I know. The best way to know we were here.
What's her extremely awkward, extremely homeschooled friend?
Oh, yeah. She watches these videos, so better not say anything. She doesn't watch this video, so she...
No, I'm sure she doesn't, but I'm also sure that she's got, you know, a pretty unique name, and,
Yeah, she does. I mean, it's a... kind of a big deal in, some Native American circles.
Yeah, deal is pretty smoking peace pipe.
Oh, let's sleep. Oh, man. Feels good to be back in the best bed in the game.
Might literally change my name to Smoking Peace Pipe now that I think about it.
Dr. Smoking Peace Pipe?
Esquire.
God, you just get so thirsty in this game.
Just like in real life, that's why I drink all the wine.
You haven't drank it all yet, though. No, I haven't. I thought we had more stuff here. Also, this is kind of a weird glow.
I'm kind of in the same boat. I thought we had more stuff here and less stuff in the place. Like, that cabinet right there, I thought was just absolutely fucking jam slam packed with shit.
I mean, we got lots of food because we got all that cooked meat in the,
In the refrigerator?
Yeah. We can run quite a bit on these books and tables and shit.
We could probably just walk around the fucking orchard and shoot some rabbits with arrows.
To practice the arrow or to get hides?
Both.
I don't know, I kind of don't want to use the bow unless we have to.
I mean,
once we get to the mountain area, I'm going to switch to bow. But before that, I'm going to fuck with it.
Why?
Because I don't want to die before we get to the mountain.
How are we going to die walking around shooting rabbits with a bow? Like,
because how often is it just remain rabbits, Dave?
Dude, there's not a wolf spawn around here.
They wander.
Dude, this is the safest map for wolves.
But not bears.
You're right, there is a bear spawn all the way down here.
Well, then why was there a bear up there by that farm?
All the way up here?
Yeah. There is no bear spawn up there. That's weird.
There's a bear spawn. I mean, you're not wrong. They do wander. But what I'm saying is that the orchard is open enough that if there is a bear around, it is not going to surprise us.
I also thought we had more hides here.
Like, that bear we almost died to, did it remotely surprise us?
No.
Right.
Anything out of here before I go downstairs and start making my pants?
Kerosene?
I was just going to leave it up here. Wait a minute.
That's fine.
Should I grab some more meat? Nah, we'll just leave it up here.
I do wish you could get to the fucking basement from inside and I have to go through the wall screen twice for essentially no reason.
Well, dude, if you could just get to the basement from inside the house, this would be bar none the best place in the game.
I mean, it's already bar none the best place in the game.
I know.
Like, I guess, theoretically, the Quinson Hut might be better.
Which one's that one?
The gas station. Because it's still got a,
It's got what?
It's still got a fireplace and a,
All these are birch saplings. So, if we found just, you know, all of the,
Some feathers.
All the feathers. All the arrows.
It's still got a fireplace and a
shit.
Whatchamacallit in it. A workbench. It's just that
12.5 hours from ready.
Yeah, ready. It's just that the fucking
wow, look at our thirst.
Yeah, I see that. It's just that the fireplace in the Quinson Hut is that shitty trash barrel that like doesn't work very well.
I thought they all work kind of the same.
I mean, I think they do, but it doesn't give the appearance of working as well because it makes even less white light than the fireplace does.
True.
Like, fireplaces get pretty bright. I know that for a fact. I spent plenty of nights sleeping on the couch in front of the one at your dad's house.
So awesome.
There were definitely a lot of nights there where that fireplace would burn so fucking bright and hot. I would, middle of winter with the heater set to 40, I would sleep in front of the fireplace with nothing but a pair of gym shorts and a sheet.
Life was good back then, Dave. We're gonna have to make more water, by the way.
That's fine.
But we never actually got water out of the toilet, so...
Right, I mean, we pull some toilet water. We got plenty of water taps, so we don't even have to...
Sure.
Purify it. We just gotta melt it. I mean, it's not remotely a big deal. See, I'm concerned about it. I don't know why you like that.
Yeah. Okay, we're doing good. Doing good. Oh.
Sweet Davy Crockett pants.
Oh, those are a lot better.
Oh, fuck. You're not wrong. Do we have, rabbit skin materials?
We are currently repairing, or no, we're currently drying out.
Drying out skin?
A skin.
Okay. I wish there were more places to fish in this game. That's really my one bitch.
I don't like it very much. I know you like it a lot. It's not my jam.
Well, there actually is a pond over here where we could fish if we want to. I just think it's a really great place to get essentially...
Yeah, the rabbit pelt's up to 82%.
Okay, cool.
I believe we have one right here. It takes two, right?
Yeah. I just think it's a really great way to get essentially free food.
No,
we need four. Somebody's trying to bust the bowl out. Or make some, we got a lot of gut, we can make just shitloads of snares.
Eh.
Put them all over the fucking place.
You want me to try the bow? I'll try the bow. As long as the weather's not bullshit. I mean, do we really want to wait on it, though?
That's probably it'd be good to learn the bow your way. Even if it really just wants to take in some practice shots.
Yeah. Fucking up one of our 5 arrows.
This place is looking to shit, so it would be one of the better areas to take some practice shots.
Oh, look at those challenges they put in.
Yeah, they're pretty crazy, aren't they?
One of them is escape from a giant bear that's following you that you can't kill. And you have to get to the trapper's cabin. And there's a gun in the trapper's cabin, so I think it's powerful enough to kill it.
The super high-bass 458 Winchester Purser.
And then there's the other one is to try to get to the top of the mountain, the new biome,
yeah,
to shoot a flare gun off. If you're going to drink so much, Dave, why do you get such a tiny glass?
It's about the smell and shit. Get the proper taste in either fucking port glass. That's why I don't drink half a bottle of
port. Then you drink half a bottle of port.
Right.
Isn't that fortified?
Yeah. It's still fine.
I hate you. I poured grain alcohol into it. Still fortified. Still wine.
remember back in the day when I used to get my pocket changed with my bottles of Wild Irish Rose.
Oh, did you tell them the time? Tell them about the time when you drank just a little bit of it and you put it in the freezer.
All the time, yeah. Me and my still buddy, Dylan's ex-buddy, Sean.
I'm going to go ahead and go back, sleep, and there's nothing out here.
Used to get drunk all the time. Still get drunk a lot, but anyway, I'd buy this shit. It was called Wild Irish Rose, and it's fortified wine. It's like Mad Dog, only stronger.
Fortified a lot.
Yeah, so the most you can make wine, like alcohol-wise, fortify it before it's taxed as a spirit.
Oh shit, that's a lot of wolves. That's four wolves.
Damn, son. So basically, if you get the alcohol content in the wine through adding,
should I go regulate?
Adding liquor to it, I wouldn't mess with it. Over 18.5%, it's no longer taxed as wine, it's taxed as liquor, which makes it cost a lot more. So, you know, there's a bit of a market for fortified wine that's fortified to 18.5%. And, back when I was totally 21, You could get Wild Irish Rose fortified wine, fortified up to 18.5% for $4.25 for a 750-milliliter bottle. Actually, I think at one point it was still $3.75. So, you know, I was pretty broke back then. But it's hard not to come up with $3.75 to party pretty hard on a Friday night. So I'd do that. There was one night I did that, and we drank just a little bit out of it. I had to do something else, so I put it in the freezer to cool down. And after doing that, we essentially accidentally freeze distilled it and had a bottle of Wild Irish Rose. That was just
all the alcohol,
just slushy and alcohol, and
food poisoning.
There was something about, well, goddamn, from eating meat.
Yeah,
shit. There was something about that that liquor that was left in there. We got so goddamn drunk.
Well, it's a good thing we're in a place where we can sleep a lot. Yeah, I pulled that out of the freezer and gave it to Dave, and it was just like,
it looked like a fucking icy.
It was bad, man. Bad.
When alcohol gets that cold, it gets weirdly thick, almost like a syrup or something. Also, somewhat related note, when you've got some buddies you're already on thin ice with, it's not a great idea to drink a bunch of Rumplemans and act like a shit.
When did that happen?
That was when you stopped hanging out with Sean.
Ah. Because of the Rumplemans?
Yeah, when they drink a bunch of Rumplemans and acted like a shit and, knocked that big-ass cup of water over and was like, Dave, why'd you spill that water?
No, dude, the worst part was when he drank all that red shit and then threw up and looked like blood everywhere, and made my dad clean it up.
No. That was, he ate something, and he drank the majority of a handle of Canadian Mist somehow and chugged it, and then, like, passed out in the armchair and threw up, you know, predictably.
As one might do.
As one might do when they somehow managed to chug an entire half gallon. Like, we were drinking a lot back then. Right? Like, there were... This was ago. There were nights when I drank a fifth of whiskey and a sixth of beer. But still, a fucking entire handle of whiskey off the reservation.
I was gonna start a fire.
That's fine. That's, I mean, it's so far beyond the pale, it's difficult to discuss.
Do we want to use accelerant or care?
Well, it only costs us an entropy as we start again. I think the...
No, we lose the tinder at least.
Still, though, I think when you get to this point, you'll be able to save the accelerant emergencies.
Emergencies, you mean?
Yeah.
We have quite a bit of it, though.
Oh, bottles.
We found two bottles once we got here.
Oh, so we got like four bottles then?
I think so, yeah.
Perfect.
At fuel.
Yeah, go ahead and burn the boots. They're kind of shit.
I wanted to melt some snow.
Melt some water and get some soup up.
Yeah. Dude, look at our thirst going down as we melt the snow for the exact purpose of...
Exact purpose of drinking it later.
I will say that I have a survival kit, and in it are the tabs, you know, the water purification tabs, and this game totally misrepresents how much it takes to clean out some water.
Yeah, one of those, the tabs are tiny, and they go
whole liter of water each. A liter? 1 liter for one tab, and there's like fucking in a bottle, and a bottle of
them. Many tabs, I've got a life straw and a tab, a little pop.
Yeah. I highly recommend getting a survival kit put together.
I get some tabs though. I need to get some better rope than mine. I've got very little rope. You see mine? We'll show you. I got mine's kind of bare bones right now.
You know, I'm moving anyway, so we might as well check them out and see what we need. Someone knows that I got a crowbar because any place worth looting, you're gonna get into. Also, weapon. Yeah, but see, I don't have a few of an axe. We got this worked out.
Yeah.
We're just never going to go apart.
Well, even when you move, you're still moving. You know, you're a little 3 miles away.
It's pretty scary.
But I've got a poncho.
Oh, you want to go to poncho?
I've got a poncho liner, which is basically just a blanket. Life straw, a couple water bottles, a good little pot.
You close.
I have separate stuff to me. We're talking survival gear.
Socks are survival gear, man.
They are. I've got little socks I keep around for that.
New selfie grinders.
Now I keep matches in a space blanket. Fire
I can't
drops.
Stand those space blankets. I need to get a wool blanket.
They have on Midway. They have Israeli wool blankets for $20 each. I was gonna order a couple. Yeah.
Is there a group discount?
I think if you buy either four or six, they do a couple dollars off. But yeah, I prefer a blanket to a sleeping bag. Because it's lighter and you can do more with it.
Yeah.
Like, a sleeping bag will be a little bit warmer. But you also can't, you know, get a piece of rope and make a sleeping bag into a coat.
True.
Like you can with a wool blanket.
I'm going back outside.
So I got that shit. I've got... My big ass, that Hudson Bay knife that I have.
See, I just have a little Mora knife. Mora knives are awesome, by the way.
Oh, yeah. If you want a knife that's, like,
sharp as fuck
and durable and very cheap, you can get a Mora knife, which is made in Sweden, for $10 or less. And they are incredibly sharp and hold their edge very well. I have butchered an entire deer with one. Gutted it, skinned it, cut it out into primal cuts. And it still was not particularly dull after that. Like, I
just... The wolves are still over there. I'm gonna kill one of them so that's run away.
It's fine. It took me a couple passes on the honing stone to get it back up to perfect. That was still entirely adequately sharp when I was done. And the real nice thing about them, they're not quite full tang knives, but they essentially are, you know, because the handle is plastic and it's over molded on the tang, so it doesn't go all the way through. It goes, you know, 90% of the way through. And the handles are, they've got really good rubber inserts molded into them, so they're not slippery when they're wet.
Me?
Yeah. It's kind of unprecedented.
I think it might have just been running, and it happened to run back this way. I mean, I don't know.
Taking it. Yeah, those Mora knives are great. I tell you, the other place that makes great knives, there's two other places that makes great knives. Condor Knife and Tool.
Never heard of them.
That, you know, that great big knife I have?
Yeah, that giant one?
Yeah,
The one that looks like cast iron or something?
Right. They made that knife, and they make all kinds of shit. That was like a $30 knife.
It's a pretty good looking knife. It's huge.
It's huge. It's got a lot of weight to it. It stays very sharp, and it gets sharp easy.
Hey, Dave, tell us more about knives while I slowly back my way out of here.
If you want a pocket knife, and you don't need something that's like super tactical, you just need a good pocket knife that will lock open and, like, you know, cut stuff. Opnol, they're from France. They are basically the Mora knife of pocket knives.
Throw a decoy, Dave.
But yeah, those Opnol pocket knives are good as hell. And they weigh like nothing because the handle is all just birch wood.
I like birch.
And they lock open. They don't have like a fancy lock.
Are those? Oh, is that the one with the spinning lock?
Yeah, that's the one where the lock is just that piece of metal that spins around the.
Hey, that's one you're on stairs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was also like a $15 knife. And the good thing about them is they're super, like, they don't flip people out because they're super non-threatening looking.
They look like a little fishing knife or something.
Yeah, they're just an old man knife. But they're super useful because they lock open. And pocket knives that don't lock open kind of suck shit.
Okay. Chairs next, I guess?
We've been going like an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think so. I accidentally just moved the bezel on.
I mean, honestly, all I was going to do was cook meat and, you know, wait until we're at perfect health to leave.
All right.
Since we aren't going to get enough of the... We weren't going to get enough pelts to make gloves.
Yeah, we're going to get enough pelts to make gloves.
So, okay, guys, this is probably going to be the end of episode 20. It looks like episode 21 is going to be us going to the mountain.
Yep. So, let's have a good night, stay out of trouble, buy some cool pocket knives.
Watch our other videos, subscribe, etc. Losers at work. See you at 21. Bye.